So let's talk about this service management in the Linux. In the Linux, there are already so many services are running in the background when you start up the Linux, but sometimes you need to start the service manually. So first we are going to look at this service command, and if you type service and hit enter, it will show you the syntax of the service command. Service option and status all to list all the services, whether they are running or not. In the service name, we need to say the command either start or stop. So let's do this service. And let me do the status all to know all the services. So I can see, as you can see, we have got some output. And the first there is a box and inside there is a plus. And it says ACPID. So this service is running. The plus symbol indicates that this corresponding service is running on my Linux computer. And minus symbol indicates that this service is not running on my computer. And you can see Bluetooth is running and cron jobs are running and CUPS printing service is running and dbus is running. And you can see the network manager running and networking running and so on. So all these services are running. And I want to show you how to install this SSH server to enable the SSH. So SSH generally gives the remote login with an encrypted connection. That's for, we use it, the SSH for remote login. So we are going to install the open SSH server. So basically you will get the SSH client, but you need to install this server. So I have already installed that, that way it says 0 upgraded and 0 newly installed. Okay, I have done this earlier. You need to install this OpenSSH server in order to run the SSH service. So to run the SSH service, you need to say service SSH start. And you need to type in the password. And if I check the status, so I can also grep this for SSH. So as you can see, there is SSH service and the plus symbol. Plus symbol indicates that my SSH service has been running successfully. Now I can log in into this SSH machine. Alright, to stop this command, we need to type service SSH stop. So again, you need to enter the password, enter your computer's password, and if we check that, we will get the SSH, but here the status indicates that minus. It means that our SSH service is not running. So one thing you need to do is, one helpful thing means, you need to run this service on the computer startup, right? If you just started your Linux computer, then if you want to automatically start this SSH service, you need to use the command called systemctl. So, okay, I will put the sudo before this one, sudo systemctl, and I need to enable this service. Enable service, what I want to run that service at the startup of my Linux. I want to say SSH. So it has created some shortcut to this systemd service. That is, it has just created the link to the SSHD daemon service to this path, so that this systemd will load the service at the startup of my computer. So to disable this service, you can say simply disable. So you can also say start SSH. This will immediately start the service, and also it will also enable the startup of this SSH service. You can see the status minus all grep SSH, and you can see SSH service has been started with also with systemctl command. Now I am going to stop this one. I can use say stop. So my SSH service is stopped now. as you can see the minus symbol. So these two commands are very important for managing services. First one is the service command to manually start or stop the service. If you want to automatically enable the SSH or any other service on the Linux, on your Linux startup, then you need to enable using the systemctl command. You can also disable it using the same systemctl command. Or if you want to right away start the service and also add it to the system startup, then you can say systemctl start that service name. So that's all you need to know about the service. If you just practice on 2 or 3 services, you'll get used to it. Okay, these two are the main commands, service and systemctl.